Hey, Kevin, what are you doing?
I was welding, TIG welding the other day, and I noticed I'm having really crappy welds. You know, they look bad. It's like it's not getting enough gas coverage. Check the bottle, bottle's full, gas is on. Click the trigger, you can hear the gas coming out of the torch, but good God, it was making a mess. And what I found when I took the torch apart was really quite amazing. But let me just back up a second and make sure everybody understands what I'm mumbling on about. So this is the TIG torch off my Everlast PowerMTS 221 STI. And if you cut that torch in half and look right down inside that hole, what you'd find is a hole coming through the neck of the torch right here. And that's how the argon gets up in here. And then once you screw your collet body along with the collet into the torch, it's going to screw in and seat right about in that area someplace. So that hole that's inside the neck is going to wind up being right about there. And that's really important, because once you screw this collet body into the torch and this section seats in the torch body itself, now the argon can come right in here and go right in between the collet body and the collet itself. And it just travels in that little sleeve between the collet and the collet body. And the argon actually comes out these holes that are down here in the bottom of the collet body. And then once you have your cup on there, now it comes out on the outside of this collet body, but inside the cup itself. And that's how the gas flows out and actually comes down onto the work as you're welding. So what I've got here are just three different collets, all the same size, but this one is brand new. This one's been used a little, and this one's, well, junk. You see, this one's a nice uniform shape. This one's wide up here, but it's narrow down there. It's got a little bulge right there. This one is the same way. It's wide at the top. It's narrow at the bottom. It's got even a bigger bulge. And what that does is it actually plugs up that little sleeve in between the collet and the collet body, that little tiny little channel in there that the gas actually flows through, because that collet swelled up because somebody, that would be me, tightened it down too much when it was still hot. And that caused it to warp, caused it to misshapen. I wasn't getting consistent gas flow out of it. And that's what was causing all my problems. So if you're just welding, you know, TIG welding along, doesn't matter what machine you're using, but you're TIG welding along and all of a sudden things are just getting worse and worse and worse and you can't quite figure out, you know, what am I doing wrong here? What's going on? That's something to look at right there. So I'm gonna go ahead and get rid of some of my problem children over here and clean up this little mess and get my butt back to work. You guys are gonna pop out to my website. Address is right there. Come see what's going on. Come out to In the Works, see what I'm working on right there. That also gives you a link to the new videos so you can see what's going on there. And I do appreciate it. We'll see you next time. So do you guys know the difference between pink and purple?